Sure. Otis was not so lucky. The tide came in so fast that the rock Otis had been sitting on was completely surrounded by water. Soon his dry rock would be underwater. The beach was far and the water was rough. Oh, he'd never be able to swim to shore. And the water was growing higher. Now the water was up to his paws. He'd have to try to swim. He took a deep breath, but just when he was ready to dive in,
not again, a sea turtle gurgled. Every time the tide comes in, some fool gets stuck out here.
Otis wasn't sure what this turtle wanted.
I say, look, do you want to ride back to shore or not? I mean, don't you know I came out here to save you?
No, Otis said. I didn't know that.
Well, now you know. Get on.
Now just stay on the shore where you belong, the turtle grumbled. Thanks for saving me, Otis said. Thanks, nothing. Next time the tide comes and I'll have to rescue somebody else. What a life. You saved mine. I save someone just about every month. Did you know that? No, said Otis. I didn't know that. Well, said the turtle. Now, you know. Huh. Oh, dear. Back to sea. Under a fresh, bright sky, Otis resumed his search for Milo. He saw in the distance an animal that he thought might be helpful. Oh, much better. Excuse me, Otis called out. I'm looking for a friend of mine. I'm looking for someone to play with, the fox said. And want to race me across the stream, eh? I haven't got time, Otis said, sensing that this fox wasn't going to be any great help. Here, wait a second. What kind of animal are you anyway? I'm a dog, of course, Otis answered. How can you be a dog? You have no tail. Otis was outraged. I certainly do. Look. Ha! You call that a tail? This is a tail. Ha, ha, ha! And with that, the fox jumped away, laughing.